Hi, welcome to InspireUI. In this video, we will be showing you how to install FluxStore into Windows machines. This tutorial will be covering four main parts. First, we're going to go through all the requirements to install FluxStore. Second, we're going to run a Flutter test drive in order to make sure that our IDEs and Flutter have been installed correctly. Third, we're going to customize the environment file to make FluxStore compatible with your website. Last but not least, we're going to run a FluxStore project. Besides, we will take a look at the common problems and solutions. Okay, without further ado, let's get started with part one, preparations. In order to run FluxStore, you have to have either Android Studio or Visual Studio Code installed in your machine. Besides, make sure that your FluxStore is running with latest stable version. Moreover, make sure that you have already upgraded your FluxStore into 2.0, which you can get from dokan. If you got any problems with the first two requirements, feel free to check out our support document guide. Part 2, getting started, basic installation of Windows. We have handwritten note here and the video for you to follow up. Now let's try to run a Flutter test drive by opening your Android Studio. Then click on create a new Flutter project, choose Flutter application, enter your project name here, and make sure that your Flutter SDK path has been pointed to where you install Flutter. Then update your project location and description, then click next. You can edit the package name here or you can leave it as default, then click finish. Upon your project structure, all of the modifications will be taken place at the main.dart file here. Now, before running the main.dart file here, let's review all our settings again. Click File, Settings. When the settings window open, click on Plugins. Make sure that Dark and Flutter plugins have been installed successfully in your IDE with latest version. Then click on Languages and Frameworks. Now make sure that Dark SDK path has been pointed to where you install Flutter. And Dartbox is enabled for your project. Double check your Flutter SDK path as well, then click OK. Now the next thing we need to do is switch to stable general by using the command flutter general stable. When it's done, use flutter upgrade to make sure you always take view of the general. Now use flutter.dart to double check all of our integrations and settings. There is no issue file, we are free to go now. Now it's time to create a simulator to run our app. Click on AVD Manager. Click on Create a Virtual Device. Then choose a device. Then choose a system image. Click Finish. And then run it. And wait for your device to be loaded successfully. This process will take a while. When it's done, click on Run button. When it successfully runs, a Flutter demo homepage will appear. Okay, now let's try the hot reload feature. This widget is holding the content of the line. You have pushed the button this many times. Now let's say I want to change pushed to clicked. So when I click on the hot reload button, the content of the widget is supposed to be changed. Okay, it changed. The hot reload is working. Now it's time to run a real Flutter project. But before doing that, we need to customize the environment file to make FluxStore compatible with the website. First, open Android Studio and click on Open an existing project. Second, point its location to FluxStore 2.0. The env.dart file is the environment file. It's holding all of your configurations, settings, and integrations. The first thing we need to do is modify our server configuration. If you already used FluxStore 1.9 earlier, you can refer to the config.dart file to fill all those values. Otherwise, you can refer to this document, WooCommerce integration session, in order to fill them. The next thing we need to do is update our app configuration file regarding your language. All the configuration files for all languages could be found here. And because we are using English as our main language, config_en.json file will be our main configuration file. This is how it looks like. If you don't know how to set up the configuration file, feel free to check out our document customize UI layout. Now in bootspec.yaml file, click on bootget to install all the packages. Let's see, it shows some warnings because we are using override dependencies, but don't worry, it won't affect your code. After that, click on run button to run your project. It may take a while. Okay, now let's see how FluxStore looks like in Android device. Okay, everything looks pretty good now, except there is a type of issue. We're using Vietnamese instead of English. Let's try to fix it. Locate widgets under the horizontal layout. Change its name from Vietnamese to the English one. And then horizontal your app. Okay, good. It already changed. Okay, we have done with the last two steps. When you install in FluxStore, if you got any problems, feel free to check out our common FluxStore installing issues. We will keep updating your issues as well as the solutions here. If none of your problems could be found here, feel free to leave us a support ticket. The technical team will give you a hand on solving this. Okay, this is the end of the video. Thank you for watching.